I would also like to thank you and your team for this opportunity to share our experience of part of the National Forest Inventory of Bhutan. So, although I have titled my presentation as talk as sharing experience of conduct of National Forest Inventory for Bhutan, both challenges and also the lessons learned, I would rather like to call it as a story of our journey of conducting National Forest Inventory. It is a journey, the story of a journey of 7 years filled with both challenges and a lot of opportunities. At this point of time, I must also confess that my friends have been reminding me whenever I talk about National Forest Inventory, inevitably I tend to become a little emotional, so which I actually don't disagree. NFI is very close to my heart for many reasons. Firstly, I started my career with National Forest Inventory. Secondly, there are many things that happened during the process of conducting National Forest Inventory, some of which are very difficult and painful for me to forget, like including one tragic accident that claimed the life of one of our city's most crew leaders. Apart from that, NFI actually taught me to be a better manager, better professional, and a better person. And also, one of the reasons that encouraged me and that brought me to the Yale University is also NFI. So for many reasons, NFI is very close to my heart. So at any point of time, if I sound a little emotional, I apologize for that. So with this, let me share our story of conducting National Forest Inventory for Bhutan. Please permit me to begin with what were the motivations or the reasons as to why we had to embark onto carrying out National Forest Inventory for Bhutan. Firstly, we have 64% of total population still living in rural areas, and their livelihood is directly dependent on the forest. So therefore, if we have to take care of or look after our people who are living in the rural areas, we must take care of our forests. Secondly, our economy is highly hydropower driven. It is dependent on hydropower, and as we all know that forest plays a very critical role in terms of regulating the flow of water in our river system. Thirdly, in Bhutan, we pursue, as some of you may be aware, a development based on a philosophy called gross national happiness. And one of the pillars for this gross national happiness is the environment conservation. So if we have to realize our development goals and objectives, we must manage our forests sustainably. And during 2009, a conference of parties of UNFCCC, Bhutan declared to remain carbon neutral for all times to come. So if we have to fulfill this commitment, we must monitor our carbon stock from time to time. And for Bhutan, the forest is the biggest sink of carbon. And above all, what we have is our constitution that mandates us to maintain minimum of 60% of forest cover for all times to come to meet the needs of both present as well as future generation. So given all these requirements that we had, motivations that we had, we embarked on to carrying out National Forest Inventory in year 2009. So we started our journey with this data user consultation workshop. As some of you may be able to see, Professor Tim is here. So at this point of time, I would like to inform that Professor Tim is one of the architects of the National Forest Inventory for Bhutan, and he has been our guide, our mentor, and our advisor. So without whose help, we would not have achieved what we have achieved. So may I request everyone to join us. Thank you so much. So from this workshop, what we did was we agreed on making our National Forest Inventory not just timber, focused on timber, but a health, broad, holistic, and ecosystem health monitoring inventory. And this workshop also adopted a broad design for our inventory. And through this workshop, we also defined targeted outputs for National Forest Inventory for Bhutan through a very consultative meeting or workshop not only involving just government agencies but also NGOs. So this whole process was divided into different phases: preparatory phase, enumeration phase, data analysis, and reporting. So let me rush, otherwise I may not get enough time. So during the first phase was the preparatory phase, where we developed design, which is a systematic grid of 4 by 4 kilometer that gave us 2,424 cluster plots spread across the entire country. And during this preparatory phase, we also worked on and developed field protocols, we developed field manuals, we developed implementation modality, we trained our staff, we procured equipments and field gears necessary to embark on carrying out actual data collection work. So, of course, this phase was also challenged mostly by lack of dedicated and committed funds that we had at our disposal, besides the HR capacity. By the way, during that time, we were just two of us coordinating the entire process of national policy. I thought at this point of time, once we complete the preparatory phase, we will have easier, enumeration phase. But then we were proved wrong. So enumeration phase actually had its own, set of challenges in store for us. Okay. So, as you can see from here, we began the, we ended the preparatory phase in June 2012. Began the enumeration phase in July 2012. As you can see from some of these pictures, it was quite challenging. As a coordinator, it was mentally draining for us, but for the field staff, it was physically challenging and risky for them. And because we have a very mountainous terrain condition, it's very challenging. Because they had to work in a very difficult circumstances and environment, to keep them sustainably motivated was a huge challenge for us as a coordinator. And there were also times when we had to carry out emergency medical evacuations, which was very challenging for us as an inexperienced manager and a professional. We managed to complete this innovation phase by December of 2015, after 3 years after we began the fieldwork. And I thought that was the end of it. We have done it and we have achieved what we wanted to. But then we were again wrong. That actually led us to another phase of challenge, which is data analysis and reporting phase. So I must honest, to be honest, we didn't have a forest statistician with us, even we don't have right now. We had the data with us, but we didn't know what to do with the data. We didn't know how to go about analyzing the data. We didn't have IT professionals with us who would help us understand the basics of database and information management system. But thanks to experts like Professor Tim and experts from FAO, we managed to overcome even this. Just to give a sense of how much we struggle is, we had a total of 3.5 million records, of which in 3 months we were three. Thankfully, by this time my management, in particular my boss, was some sort of convinced that he had some reasons to believe that NFI is important, and then he agreed to give me an additional officer. So with him, so we were three. So we worked for 3 months, and we managed to clean manually over 2.5 million records in 3 months. So, but with that, we came to the end of that data analysis and reporting phase. The happiest moment for us and for me personally was when we were able to finally launch our NFI report early this year. So it was in month of February that we managed to launch it. And of course, as I said earlier, it was full of challenges and also opportunity. So as much as it was challenging, it was loaded with opportunities and lessons to teach us. So these are some of the lessons and the opportunities that we obtained along the way. Like for instance, we have been able to build the institutional capacity of the department. We have now trained more than 50 professional forestry staff being trained in inventory, and they are posted in different parts of the country. We with this inventory, we now have a foundation, strong foundation for future periodic inventory. Mm-hmm. Not only that, we have data and information which are updated. And this data and information are going to provide very good opportunities for researchers and professionals to carry out further research and educational program. I must also make a mention here that we are very happy to inform that our NFI design and the way we approached it, the way we conducted our NFI, is being appreciated by many professionals in the region. And they, in fact, I had the opportunity to travel to countries like Maldives and Myanmar, where I could share our experience of conducting national forest inventory. Besides, a team of senior officials from the Forest Department of Government of Bangladesh visited us towards end of last year, and we met, we could share our experience. We could share with them our experiences, both in terms of design development and then fieldwork, as to how we conducted the fieldwork. And they have, of course, partially adopted our design and methodology, of course, with some modifications to suit their needs and then their environment condition. And next is, all along this journey, of course, it was full of challenges and issues, but at the same time, thanks to many experts like Professor Tim and experts from USDA Forest Service, experts from FAO, we were provided with constant guidance and advices that we managed to finally see through this massive undertaking of the rural government of Bhutan. So therefore, as much as we take pride and claim credit for success of this massive national undertaking, the credit also goes to all of these experts who have been associated with us all, through, I think, almost 7 years. And with this, I think I come to the end of my story. But let me show some more pictures so that you can get a sense of how difficult it was for our field colleagues to conduct this field innovation. How do you sleep in the forest? Thank you so much.